Hey everybody, it's Marni. I'm here to show you a recent pet commission that I completed. It's a little time lapse. I recorded it as time lapse on my phone, and then when I went to go stretch it out and slow it down, it got kind of choppy. So actually, it looks more like a stop motion video, which is cool because I like stop motion. So here you go. That's why my video is choppy. I wanted to talk to you guys today about starting your art business. Now, this is just advice that I'm giving from my personal experience, things that I've gleaned and read from the internet. This is not going to be a video telling you how to get a certain technique. This is how you get into galleries. This is simply how to sell your art from your website or social media, whether you do commissions or original art or prints or whatever. This is what I have to say. Number one, practice your skills. It was a few years ago that I realized I wanted to make a career change into art. I had always drawn growing up and I thought, hey, I'm pretty good. I can do this. But I knew my skills were nowhere near what they needed to be in order for people to start wanting and purchasing my art. I took a whole year. You don't have to do this. If you feel like your skills just need a month's time or 2 months or whatever, I took a year because, guys, I needed some work. I needed to practice a lot. In this year, I was doing things like drawing challenges. Practice, 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 practice until you are satisfied with what you're doing. Step two, get on social media early. I did this because I wanted, this is going to sound a little selfish and I'm sorry, but I get a lot of motivation from praise when people tell me that I did a good job. So in doing my art and posting it online, I saw how many likes I got comments. Not only was it a good motivator, I could get on there and see what people liked, and they even suggested things like, oh, maybe you should do this next time. Tip number three, start painting for your family and friends. This would be either as gifts or for free. Don't charge them. This is also going to give you a lot of time to practice. Number four, you should get an official website and organize your pieces either into like categories or put like colors near each other, which is what I did. Number five, you can start selling your pieces at low prices to gain interest at this time. Once you have your website, once you've practiced enough, once you have painted for friends and family, you can sell through your social media or your website or Etsy. I've found the most success with my Instagram account and my own website. I tried Etsy. Etsy's great for certain people, but to me it's a big black hole. It's a weird marketplace that I couldn't hack, and I do just as well on my own website because it's easy to remember. It's my name, MarniManning.com. Number six, as you make art for people, like if people start buying your work, even at low prices, do your very, very best. If you need to start over, start over. You mess something up, try again. Don't allow the idea of how much money you're being paid, which probably isn't going to be a lot, get in the way of how many hours you put into this piece. So it might be like somebody commissions this dog portrait. I mess up the coloring or the shading or something. I'm not going to keep muddling through and say, oh, well, I guess I just have to give this to them. No, I'm going to scrap it and start over because I need to give my very best to whatever I'm doing. Okay. Number seven, this is my last point. As you gain momentum, you can up your prices little by little to arrive at the price point that is ideal for you. If your work is well-liked, people will share it, either face-to-face, on Tumblr. Does anyone use Tumblr anymore? I don't know. Facebook, Instagram. If it's good, people will share it. If it speaks to people, they will want to tell other people. So I've found word of mouth is the best marketing tool. Usually your clients that come once, if you do a good job, they're going to come around again, either for another job that they need, or they tell a friend that that your work is good and they came to you. So actually that's how I got this commission for this sweet little puppy. A client showed a family portrait that I had done to her friend, and she liked my pet portraits and ordered two of them, which is awesome. So how to leave a good impression on people? Be your best self. Be gracious and kind when you are listening to what they want, if you're doing a commission, listen well, listen to them, take it all in, and be flexible, because things can and will go wrong. Believe me, I've had original art get lost in the mail, which is an absolute heartache. Be gracious. That's my biggest tip, I guess. So if you've watched this far, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you liked my little stop motion art video. It was really fun to make it. I love these colors. I think they're cute, purple and pink and warm and happy. And look at that happy dog. Yeah, if you want a pet portrait yourself, let me know. I've got them up on my website. You can find me at marnimanning.com. You can also find me on Instagram and Facebook. All right, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe to see more. Thanks. Mm-hmm.